Hi, Fafa.
Hello, Eric.
So it's been a week after the election. I mean, how are you coping with 335 vote defeat?
Thank you very much. As every competition will have it, there should be somebody who win, and definitely the other side. And I think that so far, regardless of everything, I've moved on. We're in the heat of examination, so definitely I need to get back on track and give it my best shot. So I'm taking it in good faith, learn the experiences I have to learn. Then moving on in the future, I'd just take all the lessons and be a better person. Yes, thank you.
But for the future, and of course in form of advice to those coming up, what would you consider as perhaps the very thing that, just one thing that led to this defeat?
Thank you very much. I think that one thing that really affected this election or my path, I think, is generally the apathy of students. I say apathy because even the voter turnout wasn't too encouraging. We had less than 4,000 people out of a population of 40,000 students voting. And at the end of the day, you ask the question, are the results actually the true reflection of what? Even if we are supposed to take a sample or representative of the student population, does it really reflect what they wanted?
Yes,
So,
10%.
yeah. So moving forward, I think that if we have something as delicate and important as this, we should make it a point, especially the stakeholders, the EC and every other person involved should make it a point to publicize it to the very best. They can call on Christian groups, they can call on other groups on campus to help in the publicity. But that all these will stem from how the people in power, that's the SRC executives, how they interact with the student population, because it shouldn't be just a sudden thing. You need them to vote, and so you try to get them on board. It should be a journey. Work with them throughout the year, make them feel a part of the SRC, involve them in activities, so that when you call them on, call upon them for something as delicate as this, they understand that they need to exercise their franchise for the leaders they want in power.
Yeah, let's delve a bit deeper as far as the journey is concerned.
Yes, sir.
I know for sure that such a beautiful lady like you running for a student office in such a big university like this, obviously you have proposals coming left, right, center. I mean, were there instances of such, and how were you able to cope with that?
Okay, thank you very much. I believe that can't be controlled. Moving forward, I had my mind on something, and so that was my focus. And everybody that came close trying to make advances, I just made them understand that for now, for me, the target was to work at getting the position. So
For later, they can be considered.
that would have been later. So I just needed them to understand that it was not a focus for me. And sometimes I will even take the opportunity to counsel that relationship is actually a big deal. So if you are getting into it, then you should get into it with everything that you have. And at that point, I wasn't interested in it, very politely. And they would actually agree and get on board if they have to. Yes.
Did you find anything wrong with the election in form of rigging?
No. I think that we put people in charge, and in the wisdom of the authorities, they had people in charge of the elections. And so until they come up or they come out to say that yes, maybe the system was compromised or not, I can't really say much. I'll just accept the results as it stands. Yes.
So election is over. What's up for Fafa?
Okay. Fafa, it's rather unfortunate that right after elections we have exams, and so Fafa intends on putting a lot of her energy into the exams and giving forth her best for it. That I would have done even if I won. So I want to take some time to reflect on every single thing, but definitely there are a lot of things that I had running for me even before the election. So when all is said and done, after a deep reflection, taking up lessons, if I have to go back into politics, just anything that would, I just need some time to do a deep reflection, and that can only be done after exams. But then, as I said, after election, before election, things are running for Fafa, so I would want to continue with my branding. I love natural hair, I love African fabrics, I run a business. I would like to continue full force. I like to still participate in student activism. So if I have to speak up for students, just anything that will keep me bubbly. At the end of the day, I'm a versatile person, and everything that I put my mind to doing, that makes me happy. That makes others happy. Volunteering. There are wonderful things that I like to continue.
Help me understand something. I mean, how is the feeling like? How are students treating you? Is it that girl who loves the election? I mean, how is it going?
I think that I have a lot of sympathizers, I should say. You have people saying, oh, Fafa, I can't believe you lost. How come you lost? What went wrong? Then I have people saying, okay, congratulations, you did a marvelous job. You really gave her a run for her money. Or, Fafa, all said and done, you are still our secretary, that kind of thing. I think it's more encouraging. And some of them are so pleased that I walk about campus so bubbly and happy. And that is the personality. It's not the end to life. For me, it's actually the beginning. Interestingly, it's actually the beginning. I love the fact that I had the opportunity to meet people. Maybe I wouldn't have taught campus the way I did during the campaign. So I see everything as all planned. Like, I believe in God so much, and I think that he knows what's best for me. And I'm so glad that I'm still back on my feet, working earnest to still give up my best for the things that I still have in hand, and more so these exams. Just anything that you have in your hands, that make sure you work best at it. And so that's what I'm doing now. So I have a lot of people saying, Fafa, we are sorry, it didn't happen. You have a lot of them saying, I didn't vote. So that's what informs my earlier submission, that there was a lot of apathy. We had a lot of school activities still taking place on that day. So you had people in class the entire time. Mm-hmm. By the time they came to vote, it was past time, they couldn't vote. So I think that, yes, it's been wonderful so far. My full force on campus is a little surprising, but for those who were for me, we are glad that I'm back on track. And I think that's the most important thing.
Well, in the lead up to the election, of course, we had youth wings of political parties here on campus, TESCON, throwing their support behind candidates. Did you enjoy such?
I must say that those things can't be controlled. They can't be controlled. Yes, these.
So, or to put it more rightly, were you supported, especially in financial support, by any political party?
No. I don't think it was said anywhere. Like, I didn't have that. For me, if I had to target such people, like Tain and Tescon, it was to get their people, because they have the number. Okay, so if you can get supporters from Tain, you can get supporters from Tescon, like there are people believing that you are a candidate. I think that was what I sought to achieve, not really seeking sponsorship from, no. If anybody would help me, they will help me because they believe in me, not that they are running on the ticket of a political party to support me. Okay, so I didn't have anybody working in the name of a political party supporting me. No.
Well, finally, looking back, are you proud of this journey? You too?
Most definitely. I'm so proud of this journey. I've become a better person, and that is the point. If you go through something as big as this, for me it was big because it brought out so many things I thought were hidden. As I said, tour the entire campus. I don't think I would have done that on a normal day. To speak to people, to understand that you actually have the power to convince somebody and bring somebody on your team, to start from grassroots, harnessing people onto your team. Because I started from scratch. I was just a normal girl who go for class, and I said, okay, this is something I want to do. So what do I have to do? I didn't have anybody from the start. I convinced people to be a part of my team. And for me, that in itself is something I should... I should be proud of. And second of all, the wonderful people I met, the interactions I had with people. I've met so many wonderful people. And indeed, had I not run for this portfolio, I don't think I would have met such people, okay, and the opportunities, you go somewhere and they're like, okay, that's the SRC aspirant, they give you an opportunity to speak, you're able to speak about issues of interest to you, okay, people hear you out, they know that you seek their interest, they want to listen. I think that is enough. That is so much I should be proud of, and I'm so grateful for the opportunity, especially from people that came. I had students who were willing to help Fafa. Just Fafa, what do you need? Fafa, can we go out? And I'm like, that is the very essence. That those minute interactions you have with people, leaving lasting impressions on them, that is the most important thing for me. Because if I was going to serve the entire student population in the office of the SRC secretary, one thing I would want to look out for is to get to that last person on the ground, is to listen to the plight of that person in Ivandi, that person in that a diaspora. And I think moving up and down, getting actually gave me that opportunity to hear their concerns and think through ways to get to them if I got to the top. Okay. Yes.
Any political ambitions?
For now, I'm still reflecting, so I don't have anything now. As I said, this is a major step I took, and if I have to push forth in life for any other thing as critical as what I did, I think that I need to learn a lot from what happened, and I'll need some time to reflect on them. So I'm in a pensive mood now, so I'll see. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Eric.